Hi poopsies, it's me, Tony Bomboni, ASMR. So today, I am going to be tracing this painting and one other painting to avoid copyright on YouTube. I am tracing my mother's paintings, which this one's finished, and then the next one I'm going to show you for this video is mostly complete, but they have just enough details for me to talk about. So make sure you guys subscribe, tap the bell, like, comment, share, playlist, and check out my website to book your very own sessions from me and subscribe to my other services, tonybomboni.com/book-online and tonybomboni.com/services. Thank you so much. That's a great way to support this YouTube channel. Okay, so let's begin. I'm using a pointer and a light to kind of like, you know, shine on different parts from time to time and just point at the paintings. So I would like to describe of a woman, and this lady has a pale complexion to her. She's quite skinny and has a narrow face with well-defined cheekbones, jaw, chin, narrow neck, slim shoulders, and she is caressing a bouquet of flowers, different kinds, lilacs, tulips, and roses. Some are pink, some are white and purple. Very dark forest green and brown stems that are super long that are portrayed below the arms. She is hugging them tight, close to her chest, covering herself with this arrangement. There are 6 flowers in total. You can see some mauve colored reds and dark purple hues and a bit of whites added onto each to create dimension, especially along the other stems. It's quite a simple painting, but it does so much. As you look at it and you wonder, who made this? What is this all about? What is this trying to show? Where does she come from? You see the purple background. It looks as if she's just being portrayed in a photo shoot of some sort. So you can see the colors there, that flower right there. And this looks amazing in sunlight as well, by the window. Even under yellow light, the color darkens and it shows up brilliantly. I believe this is some form of acrylic paint of some sort or something. I don't know, I think this is like 15, 20 years old by now, I'm not sure, but it definitely has a definitely sticking out from the background position, which tends to be difficult to do in certain lights and paints. Different paintings, you know, mixing a lot of hues of color, getting the right colors going, getting the right shape and structure, and making making it pop from the back, so making the flowers and the stems pop in front of her, and then making her pop in front of the background, and then making these not pop as much so that the arms can be portrayed more. But up close it kind of looks all two-dimensional, but when you take a step back, as a whole with any artist who paints, if you watch like Buff Rest Turns, you'll learn that it's an illusion up close. The painter has to be this close as I am, especially in the minor details. You have to really be super close, but then when you take a step back, as I am now, wow, everything looks so much smaller. These look pretty small, and although they're a huge part of the painting itself, it may be hard to tell on camera, but they look more insignificant from afar than up close. Up close, because they're mostly the center, the heart of the portrait. See how this is dominating the center of the whole canvas. The focal point is here, so it's really important to make this stand out and stick out. And I think this shines more beautifully against the purple. Painting is trying to portray, like, in my honest opinion, like a clean beauty, like a good reputation, someone with aesthetic, and someone who is secretly hiding something from the world. She's mysterious. We don't know who she is, what it's about, you know? Especially looking back again. It's like, what is she doing? Is she modeling? Is she working as a model? Or is she just... is she just having someone paint her, you know? Who is this woman? We don't know. There's no face. There's no... nose. There's no lips. Notice the shadow under her neck. I notice shadows here, again, adding dimension, the shadows under the arms. why is she holding on to these flowers so tightly? Do they mean a lot to her? And why is this one arm out here? Why is she not clenching anything there? Or is she holding something? We don't know. We can't see. The point is there's much mystery behind her, and we will never know the true meaning behind this work of art. Let's look at the other one now. Now, let's get a little closer. And this one fascinates me so much because it's unfinished. You can actually still see the stencil drawings in the background of pre-planned palms and landscapes and some leftover unfinished palms and hills that were supposed to be drawn. This is also a mystery. We do not know where this comes from. Ignoring the unfinished portion, you can see it overall looks very complete. And honestly, it's beautiful, even if it's unfinished. Part of that is the beauty and mystery of the painting itself. It's almost better that it's not finished. It looks better when it's blank. Makes you wonder what your mind can do to fulfill this missing space. Or does it need fulfillment? I personally think it doesn't need anything more. It's wonderful the way it is. And it looks full, wholehearted, and complete. And sometimes the artist is at a place in their life when they have had enough. And they put down the paintbrush their final time. And this is the result of that, and that's okay. It's not supposed to be in a museum. It just is a depiction of someone's work before they've had enough. So, this is clearly someone's home. About this painting overall, as you can see, the way it's painted from afar, it looks like